وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى, as you can all see, we're in the last 10 days of the great blessed month of Ramadan. It is from the minan and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we reach this time. وَلَوْلَاهُ, if it wasn't for him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would have been from the many who passed away, who died before Ramadan or within Ramadan but did not reach these last 10 days. So we ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he has allowed us to reach Ramadan, that he subhanahu wa ta'ala also allows us to finish this noble month and this blessed month. My beloved brothers and sisters, how could we benefit and maximize the benefits that we can take from these 10 days, inshallah ta'ala? That is what my lecture is, and that is what I want to talk about, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. The first thing that is needed from us is, number one, we need to fast. Fasting is an action itself, has a great station. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith al-Qudusi, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنُ آدَمِ لَهُ, every action that the slave does, it for him. أَمَا كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنُ آدَمِ, all of the actions that the slave, the children of Adam do, الْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا, 10 is multiplied by 10, إِلَى سَبْعُمِئَةٍ, and it's multiplied up to 700. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, some of the riwayat says illa siyam, and some of the riwayat says illa sawm, fasting. فَإِنَّهُ لِي, fasting is for me, وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ, and I am the one who rewards based on fasting. So fasting, the reward is ambiguous, we don't know it. And the scholars, they say إِبْهَامُ الْأَجْرِ, the fact that the reward is hidden, it is a dalil, it's evidence that it's vast. Because the one who is hiding it and not telling you about it is who? Allah Azza wa Jalla. And we don't expect something little from him. What we expect from Allah is what? Great and high. If a leader says to you, you know what, I'll look after you, are you going to expect something simple from him? He's a leader. When he says, I'm going to look after you, he doesn't need to tell you what he's going to do. Are we together, brothers? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِنَّهُ لِي, fasting is for me, وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ, and I will reward you, it shows that the reward of fasting is greater than what we can comprehend. Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ, anyone who does not leave off false testimony, and he doesn't leave off ignorance, foul language. مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ وَالْجَهْلِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةً أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. Allah doesn't have no desire, Allah does not want from you to leave food and drinking if what you're falling into is foul language, if you're speaking ill, and if you're coming with things that will reduce your fasting. Brothers, what affects fasting is two things. Number one is things that reduce your fasting. It doesn't fully take it away, it doesn't fully nullify your fasting, but it reduces it. The second thing is that which will nullify your fasting. The things that will reduce your fasting in terms of reward is the things that you say and the things that you do, other than eating, drinking, intimacy, deliberately choosing to vomit, and apostating. Those five, they nullify your fasting. Anything other than those five, which are major sins, they will reduce your fasting. And then now that you've entered the last 10 days of Ramadan, make sure that you stay away from those two. Number two, the second thing that we need to do in this month, these last 10 days, is Al-Qiyam. We need to stand. We need to stand for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, في الحديث الذي رواه البخاري ومسلم, that Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل عشر الأواخر, and another wording is كإذا دخل العشر, if the last 10 days entered, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم أحيى الليلة, he will revive the night, وأيقظ أهله, he will wake up his family, وشد المئزر, and he صلى الله عليه وسلم, he will tighten his waist. And the scholars, they say this means he will stay away from his wives and intimacy, and he will work excessively hard, alayhi salatu wasalam. So now that these 10 nights have entered, what is the slave meant to do? The slave is meant to awaken it up with praying. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said in the hadith al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim in hadith Abi Hurairah, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Anyone who stands up when? He stands up Laylatul Qadr with two characteristics, Imanan, believing in Allah, Wahtisaban, hoping for reward, his sins will be forgiven. And Allah, when He praised Ibadur Rahman, what did He say? وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَانِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. They spend what? They spend their night standing. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in another ayah, أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا يَحْذَرُ الْآخِرَةَ وَيَرْجُو رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. So Allah is saying, the one who's spending the whole night standing up, he's putting so much effort, is he like the one who's not? So the slave, what does he do this time? He stands up and he makes sure that he prays to Allah. Allah says in another ayah, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. Command your family, your offspring, the prayer. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, be patient upon that. ولذلك عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه, it was said that he would pray the Qiyam from Isha until Fajr. Just before Isha, he would eat his suhoor. And then Uthman radiallahu anhu would pray. ولذلك the noble tabi'i, As-Sa'ib ibn Yazid, he said, كان القارئ, the reciter from amongst us, who would lead us that prayer, يقرأ المئتين, he would read 200 verses. He would choose to read 200 verses. And when he would read those verses, he would pray for so long and for so extra until one of us would have to hold onto a stick or something. And then look what he said at the ending. وَمَا كَانُوا يَنْصَرِفُونَ إِلَّا عِنْدَ الْفَجْرِ. And they never used to pray the Qiyam except Fajr time. 200 verses of tartil, slowly, that's how they would pray. So that's what we need to do. How should we do that? If the Imam says Allahu Akbar, we say Allahu Akbar with him and we finish with the Imam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, مَنْ قَامَ مَعَ إِمَامِهِ حَتَّى يَنْصَرِفْ. Anyone who prays with the Imam until the Imam finishes the prayer, كُتِبَ لَهُ قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. What is written for you? قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. The scholars, they said, مَنْ قَامَ مَعَ إِمَامِهِ. Anyone who stands up with his Imam, there's the Imam, if it changes, if it becomes two Imams, is the Imam the one that's leading, that's meant here, or the Salah itself? قَوْلُ الرَّاجِحِ is that Salah. Even if the Imam changes, it means that if the Imam is leading and he starts the prayer, you finish the Salah from the beginning to the end, regardless of who's leading it. From the beginning of the end, then you have the reward, what brothers? It's as though you stood up the whole night. The third thing that we need to do, brothers, is a sadaqah. The Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, أَفْضَلُ sadaqah, the greatest type of charity to give is sadaqatu fi Ramadan, is the charity that's done in this month. How could a person do sadaqah in Ramadan? Two ways, inshaAllah ta'ala. Number one, إِطْعَامُ الطَّعَامُ, give food. Allah says in the Quran, يُوفُونَ بِالنَّذِرِ وَيَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا كَانَ شَرُّهُ مُسْتَطِيرًا وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. That they give those who are in need. What do they give them? وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ, they give food. Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, when I came to the city of Medina, I saw the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When I looked at his face, I realized this man is not a liar. He's a prophet of Allah. And he said, the first thing I heard him say was, Afshu salam wa at'imu al-ta'am wa sallu bil-layli wa nasu niyam tadkhulu al-jannata bi-salam. The first thing I heard him say was these statements. And from the things was what? At'imu al-ta'am, give food. The second way that you could do sadaqah is by helping a person, taftiru sa'imin, a person who's fasting, giving something to break his fast. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, Man aftara sa'iman, anybody who breaks the fasting of a person who's fasting at iftar time, you're giving something, kana lahu mithlu ajrihi, you get the reward of that person in which you broke their fast, but ala annahu la yanqusu min ujurihim shay'a. The people, the sa'im in which you gave the food to, his reward will not be reduced. Allah will give you that reward of that person who's fasting though. So this is how we should go. Number four is al-ijtihadu fi qira'ati al-Qur'an, that we exert every effort in reciting the Qur'an. And these are in two ways. In two ways, we exert every effort in reciting the Qur'an. The first one is kathratu qira'ati al-Qur'an, that we read the Qur'an as much as we can. Some of the Salaf, you all know, they would read the Qur'an so much. Uthman would finish the Qur'an once a day. And Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i would finish the Qur'an how many days? How many times a day? One in the morning, one in the daytime, and one at the night time. So Shafi'i, and he finished the Qur'an 60 times in Ramadan. And others, it was narrated other things from them. And Imam Malik rahimahullah, he used to have the biggest gathering in Medina. They said 40,000 people, some of the riwayat mentioned, used to come to his gathering in Medina to hear the hadith from him, Imam Malik rahimahullah. But when Ramadan would enter, he would close the gathering of teaching, and he would sit down to read Qur'an. And وَكَانَتْ لَهُ khatamat, he would have finishing the Qur'an in Ramadan, every 3 days you'd finish the Qur'an, Imam Malik rahimahullah. So there's many you can find in the Kitab Lata'if al-Ma'arif and the Musannif ibn Abi Shayba rahimahullah. The second thing is al-buka' inda tilawat al-Qur'an. When you read the Qur'an, that you ponder and you cry over it and you contemplate over it. وَلِذَلِكَ Allah says in the Qur'an, وَقُرْآنَ فَرَقْنَاهُ لِتَقْرَأَهُ عَلَى النَّاسِ عَلَى مُكْثٍ وَنَزَّلْنَاهُ تَنْزِيلًا قُلْ آمِنُوا بِهِ أَوْ لَا تُؤْمِنُوا إن الذين أوتوا العلم من قبل إذا يتلى عليهم يخرون للأذقان سجدا ويقولون سبحان ربنا إنه ويقولون سبحان ربنا إن كان وعد ربنا لمفعولا ويخرون للأذقان يبكون ويزيدهم خشوعا. So Allah praised them subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fact that they will cry over the Quran and they will ponder. ولذلك when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said to him, read the Quran on me. And then he said to him, أقرأ عليك وقد أنزل. Am I going to read the Qur'an when it came down on you? And so he said, I like to hear it from other than myself. So he recited Surah An-Nisa. He started what? As-Surah An-Nisa. And this is two ways of saying Surah An-Nisa. You can say Nisa or Nisa. And he recited on him until he came to the ayah, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَىٰ أَوْلَىٰ شَهِيدًا. Until he came to that ayah. And then he said to him, hasbuk, stop. He said, فَنَّذَرْتُ فَإِذَا عَيْنَاهُ تَذْرِفَانَ. When I looked, the Prophet's eyes were watering. This is what is needed from us. Number five is al-julusu fil masjid hatta tatlu ash-shams. When you pray fajr, don't move from your position. Stay where you are until the sun rises. Even if you're not doing itikaf in the masjid, sit in your position these last 10 days. Stay in that position until the sun rises. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith, man salla al-fajr fi jama'ah. Anyone who prays the salatul fajr in a jama'ah. And then what does he do? Thumma qa'ada yadhkuru Allah. He sits in his position. He remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he doesn't move. حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسِ. Until the sun rises. ثُمَّ صَلَّى رَكْعَتَيْنِ. And then he prays two rak'ah. كَانَتْ لَهُ. It is for him. كَأَجْرِ حَجَّةِ. It's like a reward of hajj. Another riwayah says, a hajj like me. The scholars, they differed on its authenticity. For now, we will take the authentication of Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani. Number six is i'tikaf, which many of you are already planning to do. To do i'tikaf in the masjid. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to do i'tikaf in the last 10 days of Ramadan. And that itself, it's a virtue. The fact that the Prophet used to do it. And the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the ayah, وَلَا تُبَاشِرُوهُنَّ وَأَنْتُمْ عَاكِفُونَ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. لكن الإمام أحمد رحمه الله in مسائل الخلال, he was asked about the reward of anyone who does i'tikaf. What's the reward for the mu'takif? And he mentioned, there is no reward I know for the mu'takif, which is sahih. There's no authentic reward for the mu'takif. But inshallah ta'ala, that doesn't mean that there's no reward. The eighth The seventh point, inshallah ta'ala, is at-tahari fi laylatul qadr. Try your hardest to find laylatul qadr. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, فَالْتَمِسُوهَا فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ. Try to look for laylatul qadr in what? فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ. In the last 10 nights of Ramadan. We don't know what night it is, but we only know that it's going to be in one of those 10 nights. And the qawl which is rajih, that Imam al-Nawawi mentions in his Kitab al-Majmu', which is the sharah of al-Muhadhab al-Ishaq al-Shirazi, that the qawl of Imam Malik and al-Thawri, Sufyan al-Thawri, Sufyan ibn Sa'id al-Thawri, and Abu Thawr, and Ahmad ibn Hamal, riwaya anhu, and Ishaq ibn Rahuya, is that Laylatul Qadr is not a specific night in the last 10 nights. It moves from one night to another. So last year it could have been the 27th, and this year it could be the 21st. It will move around. What does that make us do, brothers? It makes us put extra work in making sure that we work hard to catch that night. The virtues of it, ikhwani, is that it is better than 1,000 months. خَيْرُ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. And 1,000 months, brothers, is what? 83 years and 4 months. It's like you prayed and you worshipped Allah for 83 years and 4 months, if you catch that night and you get hold of that night. Another thing is, سَلَامٌ هِيَ حَتَّى مَطْلَعِ الْفَجْرِ. Ibn al-Qayyim in his kitab, Bada'i al-Fawaid, he says that salamun hiya, it means salamatun min al-iqab fi dunya wal-akhirah. That you're safe from the punishment of this dunya. Allah will protect you from any harm, any problems from this dunya. And also what? The punishment of the hereafter. Salamun, that's what it means. But until when is Laylatul Qadr? Salamun hiya hatta matla' al-fajr. It's up to fajr. After fajr, there's no Laylatul Qadr. You've missed it. That's why it's called Layla. It starts from min ghurub al-shamsi ila al-fajr al-thani. This is the time that the person has to work hard. Number eight is al-iktharu min al-dhikr wal-du'a wal-istighfar. At this particular time, we should make du'a, we should make istighfar. Allah says in the Quran, wabil asharihum yastaghfirun. Ibadur Rahman, the righteous people are known to what? This is what they're known to do. And Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated in his Sunan that our mother Aisha asked the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I catch Laylatul Qadr, what shall I do? What shall I do? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to her, say, Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun tuhibbul afu fa'afu anni. He told her to make this dua. So if Laylatul Qadr happens, this is the dua that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told who? Our mother Aisha to make. The Ramadan, the dua, the times that is accepted in Ramadan is 2 times. And that you should look for these two times the most. The first one is عند الإفطار للصائم, the time when you're breaking your fast. And the second one is ثلث الليل الأخير, the last third of the night, when Allah descends subhanahu wa ta'ala and He says, is there anyone who's going to ask me? I can give them what they want. هل من سائل? Is there a questioner? فَأُعْطِيَهُ. So I can give him what he asks for. If we do that, brothers, then we'll truly maximize and benefit from these last 10 days. If we don't, then as Allah said in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. You'll be from those who abandoned the reward and the greatness that could have come your way, and Allah will bring you the day of judgment dumb, deaf and blind. And if you've lost that day, Laylatul Qadr, and you miss out, what are you worth living for? If an opportunity like that was given to you and it passed by you and you did not seize it nor did you benefit from it, then what is it that you live for? Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.